سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My brothers, welcome to the graveyard, the place where every single one of us is going to be buried, the place where our loved ones are resting. My father is here, my cousin is here, maybe your father is here, maybe your mother is here, maybe you've got cousins here, and today Ghazanfar's son is here, Haji Qayyum Saab's grandson is here. Now Mujahid has been buried here, and it's just another name on the list that the angel of death gets, that he has to go and do his job. My brothers, here is where reality is. Here's where your garms mean nothing. Here's where your hairstyles mean nothing. Your social media means nothing. Here is where your gangster mindset is nothing. Here, roadman will not save you. This here is the biggest wake-up call for every single one of us. This here is a stark reminder that me and you in reality are nothing. We are only something if we choose to do good for the sake of Allah. Otherwise, this is nothing. The life we live, the way we're going around, the way we are showing ourselves, the way we think, what we think of ourselves, none of this matters when you stand here. Here, every one of these are all equal. What makes anyone better than anyone here is what good you've done in life. What makes anyone better than anyone here is how you live your life. If you choose to live your life thinking that you're some gangster or some bad man, or you're 10 men, or I'm going to terrorize and cause harm and damage to the lives of people, to the property of people, then I promise you, when you're lowered into your grave, right now, by Allah, Mujahid can hear every word of mine. As my father can hear, as my cousin Hafiz Saab can hear, my Nana can hear, and all my other relatives and all your relatives that are buried in this graveyard, how you can hear me, they can hear me. The only difference is, they can't come back and make it right. Mujahid cannot come back now and pray another salah. He cannot fast another fast of Ramadan. My father can't do that. They can't come back. The only way for me and you is forward. The only way for them is the next world. So that's why this is the biggest reminder. Because when you get here, it's on. You can't look back. You can't say, oh, I wish I prayed. Because there'll be many that will say, I wish I prayed. I wish I fasted. I wish I gave my money as zakat in the way of Allah. They will live in regret. But those who have lived a good life, the Quran will come in the form of nur. Their prayers will come. Their fasts will come. The du'as that the brothers make will come. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, إِنَّ الْمَيِّتَ كَالْغَرِيكِ الْمُتَغَوِّسِ, that the dead man, when he's inside his grave, he's like a man drowning, asking for help, mutaghawwis, seeking, who's going to come? Who's going to save me from the punishments of the grave, from the azab of the qabr? When we walk away, Mujahid will hear everyone's footsteps. When the last person that will leave him, maybe his father, grandfather, his mother's going to come. He'll know his mum's come to see him. He knows his dad's here, his brother's standing here. He knows everything that's happening right now.
Yes, sir.
It's just he's in another world. He's in a world where he can't respond to me and you. We can't hear him. But everything around will be able to hear the punishment of the grave except me and you. Even the animals hear the punishment of the grave. But we can't hear it. For if we heard the man being punished inside his grave, then we would never shot drugs in our lifetime. If we heard the punishment that a man receives or a woman receives in the grave, then we never snort cocaine in our lives. We wouldn't go and gamble in Betfred and in doing the haram. We wouldn't live a haram life. You know why? We would be so scared of the screams that come from the graveyard that we would never ever want to go. We would never ever want to go in the direction of the devil. We would never do the devil's work. We will live here and think in the moment, no. But you know why did Allah not allow us to hear the punishments of the grave? Because He wants to test us. He's only told us through His Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, the reminder that these people inside the graves can hear. There are people that are being punished inside the grave right now. What is going to relieve the punishment? But dua and istighfar. What is going to help him now? What is going to help my father now? The boys can't do much but dua. And what good are you as friends? Today you're here. Tomorrow you'll come. 3 days, in a week, you'll forget him. You'll forget there was a young lad called Mujahid. You know what? You might never forget him. Why? Because his life, the way his life was taken, is the biggest wake-up call Allah has given us today. This is the biggest wake-up call for me and you, for us to realize this here is reality. You can live in the biggest houses, bungalows, you can do what you want. You can have the biggest yard in Pakistan. You can go on the best holidays in Dubai and Morocco. You can live your life. My brother, live as much as you want. I promise you, you're going to come here. You're going to end up 6 feet under. And when we walk away, the grave is going to squeeze. When the grave squeezes, that grave squeezes to welcome. You know how a mother squeezes a child after she's lost him? That's how the grave squeezes. If he's been a good man, the grave will squeeze him like a mother would squeeze gently. If he's been a bad man, he thought he was a roadman, he thought he was a bad man, then that grave is going to squeeze him so hard that his ribs will interlock with one another. Then the two angels will arrive, Munkar and Nakir. When they will come into his grave, they will sit him up. When they will sit him up, they will ask him a number of questions. The most sound narrations mention he'll be asked 3 questions. He will be asked, who is your Lord? To which he will say, my Lord is Allah. He will then be asked, what is your religion? And he will say, my religion is Islam. He will then be asked, who is your Prophet? After which he will be asked a key question. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will be shown to him
Allah
inside his grave. And he will be asked, what did you used to say about this man?
Allah.
My brothers, how many of us have disrespected the Prophet sunnah? When I talk about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as sunnah, I'm not just talking about the beard or the turban. Have we not disrespected the sunnah when we disrespect our parents? Have we not disrespected the sunnah when we swear at our neighbors? Have we not disrespected the sunnah when we throw rubbish in the way of people when they're walking? Have we not disrespected the sunnah that we can't control our anger and we want to take a knife and go kill next man? Have we not disrespected the sunnah, not just in appearance, but in behavior? We've neglected so many sunnahs that when he will arrive inside our grave, what answer will you give? If you don't know who he is, you never lived your life like him. All you've ever seen is Bugsy Malone. All you've ever seen is Young Ads. All you've ever seen is Dr. Dre and Eminem and Tupac and Biggie. If all you've ever seen is these people, all you've ever seen is footballers. You never knew who your Nabi was. And when it matters the most inside your grave, what did you say about this man? What are you gonna answer? What are you gonna answer at that time? That's the question I'm gonna ask you. We should be ashamed if we cannot stand right now and talk about our Prophet. We should be ashamed. Because there's nobody who cried more for you than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He cried nights. Oh Allah, forgive my ummah. Forgive my ummah. Forgive my ummah. Ummati, ummati. Rabbi habli ummati. Oh Allah, don't forget my ummah. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given a dua, he reserved this dua for the Yawmul Qiyamah. He said, this dua I'm not going to make now. Every Nabi made a dua in the dunya, but I'm not going to make it now. You know, on that day of judgment, the good will in my ummah will go paradise. You know, there'll be guys in my ummah who've done wrong, who live bad lives. I'm going to go and save them. My dua is for them. But don't just rely on that. Don't be from those who will go to the hellfire, then to paradise. Be those who will go straight to paradise. Be from those that will get to paradise before everyone else. Run to paradise. Wake up and realize where you're standing right now is where you will end up. Whether it's here, whether it's there, or whether it's anywhere else. You're going to end one day. You're going to die one day. Whether it's 19 or whether it was my father's age, 51. You're going to die one day. There's nobody will live forever. Fir'aun didn't live forever. Qarun and Haman didn't live forever. You talk about wealth. Oh, I've got money stashed away in my units. I've got X amount coming in. I've got this key coming in, that key. All this talk that young lads do on the road. I'm shotting this and I'm doing that. What money? Where's your money compared to Qarun and Haman? You have no money compared to what those men had. They had so much wealth that they used to bury their wealth with them when they died. What good was it? That wealth means nothing, because in the end, they ended there as well. Even they knew their money couldn't save them. They knew their boys couldn't save them. Their armies couldn't save them. When the angel of death comes, my brother, he does not look at your status. He does not think you've got a piece in your hand, because you can't shoot him. You can't shank him. You can't run away from the angel of death. When that the angel catches you, when he takes your soul, and if you lived a bad man's life, he will rip your soul out and you will feel the pain. But if you lived a good life, a righteous life, by Allah, I swear by Allah, he will take your soul out so peacefully. You would never imagine that this man has left this dunya. He's sleeping. He rang me, this man here. Take a good look at him. You know what he does for a living? Other than working for the civil service, he washes dead bodies. He washes dead bodies. He's washed gangsters' bodies. He's washed old men's bodies. He's washed young lads' bodies. You know, when I rang him, I said, how did it go? Everything go okay? Family all right? I said, yeah. I said, how did he look? He said he was resting peacefully. He was at ease. He was calm. And he said, I've done many washing of the dead body. Many bodies I've washed. But he goes, I've never cried for anyone outside of my family the way I cried for this kid.
Allah.
That was his words today. Before Juma, he rang me. He said, I've never cried for anyone except the way I cried today for Mujahid. Why? Because how small he was, little he was. Innocent life. Nobody deserves to die that way. And the more you'd live this life, you've got gangs made up. You think you're 10 men in Ollerton, you think you're 10 men on Leeds Road. No, you're nobodies. One man on his deen is better than 100 men on the road. Remember that. Ask Maulana Ishtiaq, how many roadmans have we seen over the years come to the way of Allah? I take one name, Bilal Malik. But he rode, you think you're roadmans. If I brought Bilal here right now, he'll tell you exactly what a roadman life is. He's seen it all, has he not? Everyone knows, and I use him as tahdisun ni'mah. Look at the man of Allah now. Nur on his face. Allah. Sat in the majlis of righteous men of Allah. Every day he reads his salah. Saved his mum. Content in life right now. But you know what? We've neglected. We've forgotten. We've forgotten what reality is. We don't understand. The Prophet ﷺ said, go spend time with the graveyard. Sit in the graveyard. Spend time in where the people are going to be buried. But if you spend time there, the brother, all right.
Hey, guys, don't. Give him space, man.
Give him space. Read Rushi for him.
People have gone there.
Please, don't go near him. Stay away.
Don't worry about him. Those that know him, they'll know.
Yeah.
Guys, we're fasting, so please.
That's exactly what it is, though. There's young lads here, my brother, young lads here that need a message. No, what do you mean social media? What I've seen on social media, I've seen the good and the bad. So don't tell me about social media.
Listen, okay. Ashim, let him do.
It's not about that. It's about the message that you give to young people. It's about what you do. We're reminding people. We're reminding people about the Akhirah. We remind people about the Akhirah.
I will do dua now. As-salatu wa-salamu alaykum.
For this reason, my brothers, we need to wake up, make dua for the brother. For there's nothing that will benefit him more than dua and istighfar. There's nothing that will benefit more than that. And we'll make dua now. And everything good that I've said, by Allah, I gift it to Mujahid. I make that means for him to enter paradise. That's what we do. We give all the good to the brother.